Round up the calves, all the processed calves.
We'll see how Justin does here. This will be again, you see the weed box goes up, that big red shredding box, and you got a tank on top of that. Now these guys are four-wheel drive, but the trick is to mold the front end to the point where when you push onto the sled, the angle of the chain, it goes from the back of that board unit down to the sled, puts an equal amount of weight on the back tires. The way Kyle's rig is right now, one of these guys, or maybe two at the most, could walk over, grab the back of Kyle's truck, and kick it right off the ground. There's that much weight put on the front. So the ultimate hook with a four-wheel drive puller is to have the exact same amount of weight on the front tires as is on the back tires. If they misjudge the weight on the front, it's too light, all the weight goes to the back. If there's too much on the front, all the weight goes to the front. So it's kind of a decision made as to how many weights you throw on there. And that totally depends on the traction. The more traction there is, the more weight you need on the front of the pulling unit. Again, C-cup type pulling tires, gonna get noisy. This isn't supercharged. This one is still naturally aspirated, but it is alcohol injected. Collected exhaust. You see eight little gold funnels in there. Totally different injection system again. Each one of those funnels supplies air and methanol into each cylinder. Inside that funnel, down near the bottom, is the throttle body. There's one throttle plate in there. And Al can adjust that alcohol based on jet sizes, the feed alcohol for those eight injectors. Again, you see the wheels underneath the weight box. That's if he ends up backing up a little too fast, hitting the brakes. That thing will fall right over on its nose, and those wheels will prevent that from happening. Trail fishing tonight. The motor quick. What was that? Oh, the door wasn't shut. Maybe that's why. There you got it. Alright, again, for Colleen McCauley out of Indian Lake, just west of Wisconsin. This will be the first hook for this thing, for this motor combination. Hopefully, they got things done somewhat right here. We're going to find out. Not even lined up in the center, so Dave's not driving. Dan Holkerman, I believe, is doing the piloting on this hot rod. Piloting here, and Dan is not a professional at this either. He's still learning here. So there, we're letting him learn and put this
long ball.
There, he's got the chain tight, kill switches tight. When the green flag come out, Dan will get on the gas. We'll see what this old Chevy can do here. First time for the driver and the truck. Four-wheel drive class, the guy will run an injected four-wheel drive, versus a supercar. So the supercar motor, when the traction causes the motor to start driving down at RPM, that means less boost, less boost means less power. So they got to keep these things screaming in order to get the most power. The alcoholic engine motors, they can lose RPM and still stay in the power bank. In other words, it has a longer power bank. And you see a little bit of a zooming poking out there. You tell a different town. This is the supercar engine. It's got a root floor on it. You see the endolay injection out on top. And again, those throttle plates are going to control what he does. The amount of air he wants in there, in other words, the amount of power. You can tell by the attitude of the truck, the front end way down on the ground. He's got quite a bit of weight on the front of this hot rod, so we're going to see where this goes. Got to beat 362.5. Laid down by all Christensen and Plum Crazy. To get number two, he's got to beat 343.7 inches. We'll see where this goes. Wes has been pulling for a bazillion years. So is this unit. If things go well, we will find out.
Tightening the chain. Great work. He's got Bobcat.